based on the topic, the Bishop's Candlesticks. The Bishop's Candlesticks by Nouman is a dramatic adaptation of a very few chapters of Victor Hugo's classic novel, Les Miserables, which brings out an individual's miserable life in the hands of a very few criminal of the laws. And the transformation of the convict from a man to a beast, and again back from beast to a man, has been depicted or portrayed in a very convincing way. We get to know how an innocent man becomes a hardened criminal due to circumstances and due to the cruel society and law. We also get to see how religion to this fundamental values of oneness and equality for all human beings, charity, benevolence and amenity can set a sinful soul free so that a life full of joy and happiness can become possible. So my dear friends, let's begin the play. The characters in the play are the bishop's sister person, the convict, the maid Mary, and the sergeant with him, the three gendarmes. Thank you very much.
Then don't let me have to rebuke you again.
No, madame.
I wonder where my brother can be. It's after 11 o'clock, and there's no sign of him. Mary!
Yes, madame.
Did Monsignor the bishop leave any message for me?
No, madame.
Did he tell you where he was going?
Yes, madame.
Yes, madam. Then why didn't you tell me, you stupid?
Madame didn't ask me.
That's no reason for you not telling me, is it?
Madame told me this morning I was not to chat up, so I thought...
Oh, mon dieu, you thought? It's hopeless, hopeless.
Yes, madame.
Don't keep saying yes, madame, like a parrot in a book.
No, madame.
Very well. Where did Monseigneur say he was going?
To my mother's, madame.
To your mother's, indeed. And why, pray?
Monseigneur the bishop asked me this afternoon while you were out whether my mother was well, and I told him she was not.
Oh, so you told him that she was feeling poorly, did you? And so, my brother is to be kept out of his bed and go without having his supper because you told him that she was feeling poorly. There's gratitude for you.
Madame, the soup is boiling.
Then pour it on, you fool, and don't chatter. No, no, not like that. Here, let me do it. Do you have salt cellars on the table? The silver ones?
The silver ones?
Yes, the silver ones. Are you deaf as well as a stupid?
They are sold, madame.
Sold? Sold, are you mad? Who sold them? And why were they sold?
Monseigneur the bishop told me this afternoon while we were out to take them to Monseigneur Gobias, who often admired them, and sell them for as much as I could.
But you had no right to do it without asking me.
But madame, Monseigneur the bishop told me.
Monseigneur the bishop is a... Well, what does he want with the money?
Pardon, madame. I think it was for Madringoa.
Madringoa? Madringoa indeed? What? The old witch who lives at the top of the hill and says that she's bedridden because she's too lazy to do any work? Why does she want the money for?
It was for the rent. The bailiff could not wait any longer and threatened to turn her out today if it were not paid. So she asked help to Monseigneur.
Oh mon dieu! He gives away everything. We shall have nothing left. His estates are sold. His savings have gone. His furniture and everything. And now my beautiful, beautiful salt cellars.
Oh, I'm sorry, madame. If I had known.
Sorry? And why? Pray? If Monseigneur the bishop chooses to sell his salt cellars, he might do so, I suppose. Come on, wash your hands. The disgrace is really dirty.
Yes, madame.
So warm and comfortable it is inside the house. I would go out again and again just to feel this comfort. Well, sister, you seem to have been fine. Mary, have you been troublesome at all?
No, it wasn't Mary, but...
Well, he's just going to represent me. And Mary, I've seen your mother. The doctor's been there too. She's fine, but she needs to take absolute rest, and you have to take care of her, all right? It's late and cold. Go home now. Ah, and Mary, take my comforter. It's very cold outside. It'll keep you warm.
No, no one thank you.
What nonsense, brother? She's young. She won't hurt.
Dear, we haven't been outside. It's very cold.
Brother, I have no patience with you. Here, sit down.
Very well.
And take your seat. It's been waiting ever since so long, and if it spoils, it serves you right.
It smells delicious, dear.
I don't think Mary's mother is so ill that you need have stayed up on such a night as this. I believe those people just pretend to be ill, just to have the bishop's call on them. And you know what? They have no thought of the bishop.
Ah, dear, I find it kind of them to want to see me.
Well, for my part, I believe that charity begins at home.
Yes, indeed. And so you make me this delicious soup. You're so good to me, sister.
Good to you. Yes, I should think so. I would like to know where you would be without me to look after you. The dupe of every idle scamp or lying old women in the parish.
Dear, if people lie to me, they are poor and not me.
But this is ridiculous. You'll soon have nothing left. You'll give away everything. Everything.
Dear, there is so much suffering in this world, and all I can do is so little, so very little.
Suffering, yes. But you never think of the suffering you cause to those who love you the best. The suffering you cause to me.
You, sister? Have I hurt you? I remember you had been crying. Was it my fault? What have I done? I'm sorry.
Sorry? Yes. But sorry no one meant it. Go on having your soup before it gets too cold.
Very well. But I should know what's been depressing you.
You are like a child. I can trust you out of my sight. No sooner is my back turned than you get the little minx Mary to sell the silver salt cellars.
The salt cellars. It is a pity. But I never knew you were proud of them.
Proud of them? Why? They've been in our family for years.
A pity indeed. They were beautiful. But I suppose you know, dear, that one can eat salt just from a tiny distance as well.
Yes, or meat of the floor, I suppose. Yeah. Oh, it's coming to that. And that old wretch man Ringoa, I wonder she had the audacity to send her again. The last time I saw her, I gave her such a talking that it ought to have had some effect on her.
Oh, I had offered her to take her in for a day or two, but she refused, saying that it might distress Miss Poisson.
Distress me?
Yes. And the bailiff, who is a very just man, wasn't doing any wrong for the rent. So you see, I had to pay it.
You had to pay it?
Yes. And you know my financial condition. I didn't have any money left. So don't you think it was fortunate of me having those salt cellars so that I could dispose them off, get money, and look around?
Oh, go on. You're incorrigible. You'll sell your candlesticks next.
No, dear, not my candlesticks.
Oh, why not? I suppose they would pay somebody else rent.
Well, that's so good of you to think so, but they mean a lot to me. They were a gift from our mother, as you remember. So I won't think of selling them.
But, Brenda, you break my heart. Give me your blessings.
You will always give you money. Good night.
Don't sit up too long and tie your eyes.
I won't, dear. Good night.
I want no keys. I have a voice inside me, tearing at my interest, tearing me. Give me food. Come, tell me where the food is.
So why you lock the cupboard? Come, my friend, you have nothing to fear. Me and my sister, we are alone in the house.
How do I know that?
Well, because just tell you.
Iris, but mine, blame me for it, and as sure as there is in hell, I will drive my knife to your heart. I have nothing to lose.
You have your soul to lose, my son, which is far more valuable than my heart. First home.
Yes, brother.
We have a poor traveler who is hungry here. Would you mind coming out and giving me the keys of the cupboard so that I provide him something to eat?
What? At this time of night? A pretty business, truly. Are we to have no sleep now, but to be at the beck and call of everyone who comes? Oh, gosh.
Oh, dear, please. He's hungry.
Very well, I'm coming.
Brother, why does he have a knife in his hand?
Well, dear, don't worry, all right? It's all fine. Maybe he supposed I had sold mine, so he bought his own. I told you before, he's very hungry.
Brother, I'm frightened. He glares at us like a wild beast.
Hurry! I tell you, give me food. I'll stick my knife in your boat and help myself.
Then give me the keys and you can go back to bed.
Stop! Neither of you leave till I do.
Person, I suppose this gentleman evidently desires you to accompany him for supper. Would you spare a few moments for him?
Very well, brother.
Put them on the table and stand in front of me so that I can see you.
In hell,
The night I was sentenced, the caller told me that my virginity, she was dead. Damn them! Damn them all! God, curse them all!
My friend, tell me about the prison ship, about the hell you went to.
Tell you about it?
No.
Look at me! I was a man once, now I'm a beast. They have made me what I am. They changed me like a wild animal. They laughed me like a hound. I fed on filth. I'm covered with vermin. I complained. They laughed me again. But that was 6 weeks ago before I escaped. I escaped and I was free. I was free to stop.
What do you mean by that?
Yes, to starve. They feed you in hell. But once you escape, you starve. They were hunting me everywhere. I had no passport. I had no name. So I stole. I stole again. I stole this rat. I stole my food daily. I better don't ask for work. I need not go to beg to the town. So I stole. They have made me what I am. They have made me a thief. God, curse them all!
My friend, I know you have suffered and endured a lot of pain. But never forget, there is hope for all.
Hope.
My friend, you are tired and drunk. I assume you must take some rest now.
Yeah, I love
you. I'll get you some coverage.
Silver. By God, heavy. What a price.
My friend, you've been admiring my candlesticks. They were a gift coming from my mother. They mean a lot to me. Well, it's late. What do you lie down now? Your coverings are here.
Are you sure no one will come?
Well, if they do, I am not my friend.
Your friend?
Yes. Nobody molests the bishop's friend.
The bishop's friend. Are you sure that no one will come?
Well, I'm sure. But even if they do, you lock the doors and guard the windows yourself, haven't you?
I wonder if it's safe. Go to your bed. Go on.
Yeah. I'll go on. Good night, my friend.
No, what? Of course! Curse it!
I will have another look at them.
What? Hundreds? I will borrow it. If I had turned them into money, they would start to fear. The old boy was fond of them. Said his mother gave him them. But... yes! They didn't think of my mother! When I was sent to hell, he was kind to me too, but what a bishop, except to be kind to me. Cheer up, Hathi, you're getting soft. One of my chainmates laughed at me by seeing that 15729 getting soft just because he felt good. Good, ha 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 ha, good, ha ha. That's a good one. No! I will take his candlesticks and go. I will not stay till the morning. If I stay, he will preach at me and I will become soft. No, I will take his candlesticks. Here goes!
What's that? Oh, there I say! Are we to have no sleep tonight?
Who is that? I'm sure I heard the door shut. No one?
No, No, they were here, right? You could have at least left me those. They were everything to me. You knew that. Gosh, it's hard for me.
Brother, go and inform the police. He might have not gone far. Once you inform the police, then you get back your candlesticks again. You don't deserve them though. Leaving such a person like that all alone in the house.
But so you're right. It's all my fault. I led him into temptation.
Oh, nonsense. I led him to temptation indeed. Go and inform the police. I knew he was a common scoundrelly thief. If you won't, then I will.
No, first of all, please don't inform the police. He will be sent back to prison. Sent back to hell. No, this shouldn't happen. Well, I used to feel that maybe I'm greedy to keep those candlesticks for myself. And now God has punished me for that. It is a just punishment. Leave it, forget it.
But, brother.
But, senor, we have something for you. Maybe enter. Enter myself. Bring him in.
Oh, so they have caught the villain. Have they?
Yes, madam. We found this scoundrel slinking along the road. He wouldn't show us his papers, so we arrested him on suspicion. Holy Virgin, wasn't he strong and didn't struggle? But we still caught him. While struggling, these candlesticks fell out of his pockets. We realized that these belong to Monsignor the Bishop. So we have brought them here so you can recognize them, and then we lock him up.
I don't understand. Why have you arrested this gentleman, who is a good friend of mine?
Your friend, Monsignor? Holy Virgin! Well!
Yes, my friend. And the candlesticks, I myself gave him those as a gift. Because he did the honor of having supper with me tonight.
You gave him? Him your candlesticks? Holy Virgin!
Remember my son, she's holy. Pardon, Monsignor. Now I assume that as he's your bishop's friend, you may let him go.
But he won't show us his papers.
I assume it's enough for you to know.
But surely...
Enough. I...
Lose the prisoner! Right! About done! Forward! March!
You scoundrel! You pitiful scoundrel! Your bot, your fed and wound! And still you thief! Steal from your benefactor! Oh, you blackguard!
Sister, you are overwrought with anger. Go to your room and leave us alone.
What? To leave you with this person to be cheated again? Perhaps murdered? I will not.
Pursue my vision. Please leave us.
Very well. If I must leave, then I'll take these candlesticks with me.
Stop, Pursue. Keep the candlesticks on the table and leave.
I will not.
Yes, you will. Because I, your bishop, are commanding you to do it. Now you may leave.
I'm glad I didn't get away with those. I'm glad. Curse me! I'm glad.
My friend, there is no need to be upset. Aren't you tired? See, I think you must rest now.
No, I did not. Besides, I must go on. I must get to Paris. It's big. I must get it lost there. They won't find me there. But I must travel in the night. Do you understand?
I understand. You must travel at night too. Not be caught by the gendarmes.
I didn't believe there was any good in this world. One does not when one has lived in hell. But somehow, I know you're good. It's good to ask, but could you bless me before I go? I think it may help me.
My blessings are always with you. May God give you success in whatever you do.
Good night.
Stay with myself.
Beast.
My friend, never forget who things in life. Never lose hope. every situation can get better, however worse it may be right now. And second, this body, it is the temple of the living God. Two things you have to remember forever.
Temple of the living God. I will remember.
Patience and strength to overcome his past.